Hey Saki, want to learn how to make a greeting card out of like an egg? Any way I could get you to put some bunny ears on for a video? Really? I'm asking you so nicely to let me just put these adorable bunny ears on you. I wish that you'd be a little cooler about this. Please? It's for a video. What if I give you an egg? Will you do it then? Let's get our supplies together for this project. First, you're going to need an egg. You can use an uncracked, hard-boiled egg, like the kind you use to dye Easter eggs. The problem with using a hard-boiled egg is the person can't save it. It will be destroyed the second they crack the shell. And it's really not reasonable to expect somebody to keep a hard-boiled egg forever because it's going to start to smell. So, you could hollow out a raw egg and make this project using just the empty eggshell. But be aware that empty eggshells are very fragile, and I hate to think of you getting most of the way through this project and then accidentally cracking the shell. So, that brings us to the land of simulated eggs. If you visit your local craft store or large Walmart-y type place, you'll find a ton of different types of eggs to decorate, especially in the spring. There are wooden eggs, plastic eggs, paper mache eggs, ceramic eggs, styrofoam eggs, and on and on. Now, obviously, different materials work better for different projects. For this project, I highly recommend hollow plastic eggs with a matte white surface. These plastic eggs look just like the real thing, and they're very inexpensive. You can get a dozen of these things for less than $5 at most places. They're no good for any kind of project involving heat because they're made of a very thin plastic, sort of like a ping pong ball, and they can melt. But for this type of project, they're great. So you're also going to need stamps for adding designs to the egg. Stamps mounted on wooden blocks will work for this, but it is a little bit easier to use clear stamps. Smaller images are the easiest to stamp onto a curved surface, and I'm going to use these adorable little bunnies today. And you're going to need ink for stamping. If you do a lot of stamping and coloring, you want to choose whatever ink you normally use for your coloring. But if you're using these plastic eggs, remember that you cannot use a heat tool for drying the ink. I learned this lesson the hard way. It will melt the egg. So because of this, I'm using black stays-on ink for this project. Stays-on ink is a lot like Sharpie ink. It's permanent and smudge-proof when it's dry, and it does dry without the use of a heat tool. Make sure to have your stamp cleaner on hand because you always want to clean your stamps well after using stays-on ink. It's not necessary, but it is helpful to have a fine line black permanent marker on hand for this project. You can use it to draw additional elements onto the egg after you're done stamping, and I'll show you that a little bit later. You're going to need some place to rest the egg while you work. Look around your house for a small candlestick holder, a shot glass, some type of bottle cap, a napkin ring. You can even take a piece of craft foam or cork board and stick 4 pins into it and make your own egg rest, or make a little ring out of a piece of wire, or even use a small roll of tape. You just want to be sure that you have a spot ready when you need to put the egg down to dry. Pro tip, eggs can roll.
And finally, you're going to need a way to add color. You have a lot of freedom here. You can use markers, watercolors, acrylic inks, colored pencils, whatever you want. Think about the various ways that you add color to a typical greeting card. I'm going to use Prismacolor markers, and then maybe I'll zhuzh things up a little bit with some foil highlights at the end. Now that we've got our supplies together, let's make some art. Now that your supplies are together, it's time to stamp the egg. Arrange your work surface like you normally would for stamping, except instead of a paper card in front of you, you have your egg on its stand. You won't be able to use a stamp positioning tool for this project because those things only work on flat surfaces. So use the stamp either on a small acrylic block or just alone depending on the stamp. I'm right-handed, so I hold the egg in my left hand, and then I sort of roll the stamp over the surface of the egg. You can move the egg under the stamp, or you can move the stamp over the egg, whichever comes more naturally. A lot of it depends on the shape and size of the stamp that you're using. Very small stamps can sort of be dotted onto the egg, while sentiments might need to be rolled onto the surface of the egg. And you might find that you screw it up. That's why it's good that these plastic eggs only cost about 30 cents each. When you mess up, don't throw the egg away. Keep it as your experimental egg to mess around with later. I have one of these things that's had pins stuck into it, pieces cut out of it, all kinds of stuff. Screwing up just means that you now have a practice egg. If you manage to get it done without screwing up, good job, you're a natural. Only stamp half of the egg at a time, otherwise you risk smearing the ink. After stamping the first half of the egg, position it on the egg rest, ink side up, to dry. When the ink is dry, stamp the other half of the egg, and then set it aside to dry with the wet ink facing up. If you're using stays-on ink, you shouldn't have to wait very long for the ink to dry. I like to stamp one side of the egg with an image and then stamp a sentiment on the other side. When all of the stamping is dry, I like to sort of connect the stamped images using my fine line marker. For this egg, I'm adding some grass and clouds, but the possibilities are endless here. You can do whatever you want.
So, I cooked an egg up for you. I thought maybe if I gave you an egg, you might let me put those bunny ears on you. Come on, come get this egg. All right, sit down right here and I'll feed it to you. Come on, sit down right here. Sit down. I'll feed it to you with this tiny fork. Sit. Why aren't you sitting down? Please sit down. Thank you. Eggs are good protein, aren't they? Yeah. Listen, when we're done eating this egg, you're gonna go ahead and let me put those bunny ears on you, right? Eggs are good.
Now comes everybody's favorite part, adding the color. At least that's my favorite part. I'm using Prismacolor markers because they're smudge-proof and they lay down very vibrant color on these matte plastic eggs. Just be careful as you color. Take time to let colors dry before holding the egg by that spot, or you'll smear the colors and then you'll have to play it off like you were going for a tie-dye effect. When you're done coloring, you can add sparkle and dimension just like when you make any other card, by gluing down metal embellishments, using foil, ribbon, buttons, whatever you want. Go nuts. Just, again, two words of caution. Be mindful of giving things enough time to dry as you work, and don't use embossing powder or a heat gun on these plastic eggs.
Let me put these on you. Come on. Why not? What's the problem? I get it.
Now, you don't have to do this part, but one thing I like to sometimes do is glue a small flat button onto the bottom of the egg so that the person can stand it up on their desk or whatever. Don't use a hot glue gun to attach the button. You might melt a hole in the egg. Another tip when giving these eggs, if you go over to your local dollar hauler or Walfart shopping arena, you should be able to find some plastic hinged eggs for about a dollar. You know, the kind that you put candy in for kids' Easter egg hunts? Get the larger size of those and use one as a sort of envelope for your egg card. I like to tie a ribbon around the outside, maybe add a little tag, and then the person finds a nice surprise when they open the outer egg. Presentation is everything. And here's my finished egg. I added a little bit of sparkle with a glue pen and some foil, and I'm pretty happy with how this all turned out. I think I'm going to give this egg to my nephew for Easter this year. Well, this concludes my second so-called instructional video. What did you think? I tried to make this one a little bit less than 14 hours long. Got a bit of a Kubrick problem I recently discovered. Anyhow, let me know how I can improve these videos in the comments below. Or maybe tell me what kind of video you'd like to see in the future. Maybe you want to go to my Etsy store and look at some of the stuff that I'm selling there. I don't know. There's a link below. Perhaps you'd be willing to like and subscribe and help me grow my channel. But at the very least, I do want to say thanks for watching, and I hope you have a great rest of the day. And I'm out like that.